Over the last 10 or 15 years, we've all hoped that North America blossomed to the sounds of electronic music, and there's been a couple of blips and points where we thought it would happen, but it unfortunately didn't. But the last 2 years or 3 years, we've seen a growing development of, you know, pop music or pop electronic music, which has opened the doors and kind of brought our, you know, our sound to a wider audience, in a way desensitizing, you know, the next generation to the sounds that we've been making or the sounds that we've believed in for the last 25 years. But if we want to be part of that, of this explosion, if we want to give kids and the next generation a chance to find different shades or deeper shades of electronic music, we are great, fine candidates to make that happen. You know, in a way, I think we feel it's our responsibility to take what we've learned over the last 20 years and help this transition of change and new understanding of electronic music continue to grow and develop and go deeper, and not just stay where it is in the pop realm, or not just disappear like it has in the past. So we thought the best way to do that was how we've always done things, remaining the, in control, going in a grassroots mentality, and putting together this tour and hopefully a series of tours that bring together incredible artists and bring momentum and an event that creates a momentum for a different sound of electronic music that is perhaps not so prevalent in North America right now. That's why we called it, you know, Control, to take control and bring the music back that we love, and why we called it Beyond EDM, because EDM is a very specific term that's probably misunderstood, and we want to kind of break the chains of that definition and show that how wide the definition of EDM should and can be. I don't expect that we're going to turn every new electronic music listener in North America or anywhere in the world into what we're doing or to like what we're doing, but we spent the last 20, 25 years of our lives believing in this and working very hard to you know, stay the course for what we believe in. You know, we've all had a long burn mentality. We haven't changed our musical style. They may have developed, but there's been this continuity in what we do. But we want to open that door so people can come into that sound. And you know, if we don't take it serious and be part of that new discovery, you know, why have we been wasting all this time for the last 20 years? This is part. It's if we have a job, it is part of, it's part of our job.
It is hugely important for people in your position and now in my position to be part of this and to keep this culture going and put out the right aspects of this culture for people to be able to explore, so they know that there is an option. Because once you find out of that option, especially as me, I was a teen growing up, when I first started going to your guys' parties, it expanded my mind so much just to the cultural possibilities within this music and the technology and like the ideas that really grabbed me. And if kids don't know that's there, you know, I know when I first started going out or like listening to electric music, I'd go to HMV and buy CDs that you could get over the counter. That's just the first entry point. But if there's other, like, it's kind of like, kind of in a way like America, if you don't see that there's more out there and that's the only view that you have, then that's what you will stick to. But if people can come in who have credibility and can culturally and kind of musically show them the right light and the right directions, it can be hugely important, especially in this time that we are now. It's amazing to be at the party kind of that birthed me in a way that really, I remember Control 2 changed my life, my whole perspective of things, and now being on the same, I guess, series of parties, Control, is pretty phenomenal.
To take the analogy of the disco ball, you know, right now I think in North America, what's being promoted and listened to and programmed at most of the festivals or events is just one or two of the glass pieces of that disco ball. You know, there's so many facets of this music. It goes so deep and so varied. You know, Dice and I are connected, but he plays in a different style, comes from a different background. Ian plays in a completely different way, but these are all, you know, other facets of that disco ball that we want to start expanding so that people get the whole picture or get the whole light of that, of the possible experience of electronic music.
it's our moral responsibility in many ways.
The plan is to promote the underground to the mass. So I've joined the company on June 1st last year, and now I have festivals, I have concerts, and I have nightclubs all over the country to be able to promote that to the mass.
I have the feeling that, not I have the feeling, I know something is happening there, and we have to be there now to represent our music, represent our scene, represent ourselves. When we started in Ibiza or in Europe to doing our parties, it was always about us, we. And it was always not only one DJ, and this is how I saw it in the past, even with the United States, you had one DJ or two DJs controlling or talking. But now the move is like, we are not just one. Rich is inviting, I don't know, 10, 20 DJs, artists to control. When I do a party, I invite not just only my Desolat crew, I have also a lot of guests. And I think this is the key of it, because together we can be stronger than anyone else there and to represent our thing, what we are standing for. And like Seth said, it's a spiritual thing behind that whole thing as well. What we are feeling, because it's not just a money machine like other
people.
We're
all successful at the end of the
day. Of course, it's business and all that stuff, but we are standing for something. And it's not, we don't want to control the market. We don't want to take over the stages or whatever it is. We just want to represent what we are doing.
What we're seeing with this, you know, the EDM craze, I think is really a great thing in the sense that it's exposing a much larger audience into a realm that we don't have to try to continue to describe anymore. It's, you know, for so many years we've been trying to describe what we're doing and why this is really music and why this is so relevant. And you know, our background has always had the clarity that electronic music and technology really move at the same pace. So it's constantly evolving. There isn't any sort of limit that has been reached yet to where we can put that on a shelf and move to the next realm of electronic music. It's still really evolving. And I think that seeing the refined projects like this tour that's coming up and the course that has been maintained by a lot of techno DJs is incredibly important because of the fact that, you know, music is just like wine. There's a big range, there's a big spectrum, and the difference between, you know, fine electronic music is really distinct. And being able to, you know, work on projects in Detroit for so long and producing the festival now has always maintained that. And it has certainly not been, you know, the winner of popularity contests. We are not the biggest festival in the United States. We're still kind of the little engine that could, if you will, if you compare it to some of the larger, more massive festivals that are happening. But we've maintained that course and we've really tried to stay, you know, true to our not just original inspirations, but, you know, after 20 years, those inspirations have stayed, you know, incredibly, you know, authentic in the sense that it still is really all about the sound. And the producers and the DJs and the promoters that are putting sound first will stick out, they will last, and ultimately, when this EDM wave passes, the next wave is gonna be, you know, one that's a little based on integrity and intelligence, where people are, you know, sort of wondering, what is this really all about? And then once they're introduced into that wave, I think you're gonna see a lot of really incredible things happen, not just in the US, but you're gonna see a network strengthen across the globe that's based on the same ideals that we're talking about.
After DJing myself for 10 years, I felt a responsibility to preserve the culture differently. I felt that as record stores were disappearing, that there needed to be a replacement, a place where people could come together and preserve the wonderful, wonderful history of DJ culture, both in terms of teaching them how to use the technology, teaching them where we came before, and teaching them how to create a great set that transcends hits, that actually can coalesce music together into a unique experience for the dance music fans. So I feel like it's many of our personal responsibilities to also educate the DJs, you know, tell them about guys like Rich and help show them how to use technology to do amazing, amazing things. Right now is an amazing time in DJing because creatively speaking, the palette is wide open and you can literally create your own reality.
You know, to make a difference and to, you know, open this doorway even more for this next generation, it works on a number of levels. You know, the level of the EDC events, of having a kid stumble upon what we're doing and what we're playing, to browsing online at DJ Tech Tools and being part of that online community. But there's something missing, and that's part of what the tour is about. You know, going through in smaller venues in a short amount of time, and actually reaching out and nearly touching the next generation and talking to the next generation physically, because it's, you know, watching a star or a superstar DJ on a platform, you know, 200 meters away with 50,000 people is an exhilarating experience. But there's another part of that equation is, you know, sitting in a room like this and seeing maybe, you know, your favorite DJ or just someone talking about something you're just learning about, and then maybe having a chat after and feeling that, you know, you can, this maybe this dream of getting into electronic music on a deeper level is attainable. The music in the scene is, you know, so tied between music and technology. Everything is evolving, and this tour for us is meeting the next components of that evolution that will help us evolve and bring our scene to the next step together in a way that perhaps we feel will be better than the way it's being delivered or done right now. The tour has two components. So each night, of course, we're doing a showcase with Dice, myself, Ean, and a rotating cast of characters, Seth, Kevin Saunderson. But in the day, we'll be doing a two-hour program at colleges and universities, which will be, you know, loosely, it won't be so technical. It's more about, I keep saying we want to educate and inspire, but I think our main purpose is to go into these towns and colleges and inspire first, and that will be the first step to those people looking deeper and educating themselves. Things don't become big in America, in my opinion, because they're driven by passion. It's just driven by money. Yeah. You know, and so we're there now to drive the scene to another level or its next step by passion. I don't really care what's on the top 10 of Beatport. As long as more people are buying or listening or wanting to be a bedroom DJ, this is all mm-hmm. a positive step for electronic dance music.
Absolutely.
And this is the right moment for us to try to let more people discover all those shades and all the different ideas that we represent and believe in.
And our wave will not break.
I think we're at an incredible point in the development of electronic music, and, you know, not only in North America, worldwide. And I think we've proven our point of staying steady to the cause for the last, you know, 10, 15, 20, 25 years, and putting our, you know, working hard and putting our passion and integrity on the line and keeping it authentic wins in the day, you know, at the end of the day. You know, it's, this explosion will kind of subside. You know, the music that we stand for will never, you know, maybe there'll be a couple of us who have a pop hit here and there along the continuum. But this music isn't for everybody, like I said earlier, but through spreading the word by passionate people, there's a whole lot of people that we can infect who will have that epiphany of putting two records together or being on a dance floor and hearing a DJ make a new song that only happens for that moment in time. And you know, like Seth probably had on our dance floor, and then kind of putting his life on hold and following that direction. Same as when I heard, you know, when I first met Derek May at a record store, and really, it wasn't even about what he said. I don't know what he said to me, but he had so much crazy energy, as anybody who's met Derek May knows, and I was like, man, this guy's incredible. He's a crazy wizard. And that resonates to me to this day.